वेलकम टू प्रॉप गाइड शो. माई नेम इज श्वेता तलवार एंड विद मी इज मिस्टर अंकु धवन, चीफ बिजनेस ऑफिसर रीसेल्स प्रॉप टाइगर. वेलकम टू आर शो मिस्टर धवन.
थैंक्स श्वेता.
सो मेनी न्यू एंड ओल्ड हाउसिंग स्कीम्स आर ऑफर्ड नियर एक्सप्रेसवेज. हाउ शुड द एंड यूजर लुक एट दीज प्रोजेक्ट्स?
सी, व्हेनेवर दीज एक्सप्रेसवेज आर अनाउंस्ड, इट्स अ गुड न्यूज फॉर द रियल एस्टेट सेक्टर. व्हेनेवर दीज एक्सप्रेसवेज व्हिच आर अनाउंस्ड व्हेन गेट कंप्लीटेड, टिपिकली द प्राइसेस अराउंड दोज लोकेशन विल इंक्रीज. एज द डिमांड इंक्रीजेस, देन द एरिया सराउंडिंग इट विल हैव अ बेटर कनेक्टिविटी टू द सीबीडी, द सेंट्रल बिजनेस डिस्ट्रिक्ट. So the pricing and the demand in of that area increases, and that's why a lot of people start buying houses close to it, whether it's a new scheme or old scheme. Now, question which you have asked is whether end user should buy it or not. My sense is the end user should not start investing in these schemes until unless they have very clear visibility in terms of the project completion timelines, because these projects are very risky. We have seen multiple infrastructure projects which have been announced but not yet complete. So in that case, end user will get stuck and will have a problem in staying those houses where the infrastructure itself is not there. But still, there are some schemes where you will know the infrastructure is being developed in areas which is habitable, so you can still live there even if the infrastructure is not there, and it will always add to the benefit of the society, benefit of the locality. So in that case, an end user can look at. So someone, like example, if you take a Delhi Meerut Expressway which has been recently announced, it goes through the areas which are habitable, whether it's Vaishali, Kaushambi, or Pratap Vihar which is getting developed, or Lal Kuan, Dasna. They are societies which are livable, you can have connectivity to different areas. Widening of NH24 will add to the connectivity benefit. So you can still look at these projects where end user can today also live and have a house.
Lot of new expressways are being announced. So should the investors buy land or houses near these upcoming expressways? And if yes, what time period should they look at?
See, for investors, it's always a good investment if you're looking at a new infrastructure which is getting developed. That's why what we have seen is that as soon as the infrastructure is announced, lot of investors start buying property around that, so that they get lock-in of a lower price and they can sell whenever the infrastructure is complete at a higher price. So that is always a good investment. But now question is, what is the risk involved in such infrastructure investment? And they should know those risks before they start investing in those areas. If you look at the examples of Dwarka Expressway, so Dwarka Expressway, whenever it was announced in 2007-8, lot of investors thought this would be completed by 2011, which did not happen. So what happened, these guys are now stuck with the investment. So anybody who has invested in 2008 and if he had not exited by 2011 or 12, then he is stuck with the investment. Now the prices are not increasing. But similarly, if you look at the old ring road, let's say take example of old ring road in Bangalore, whenever this project was announced, people would have bought homes close to it. And now that road is ready and the prices are now really shot up. So it depends upon the investor and what kind of risk involved in the infrastructure development itself they need to take. Typically, I am assuming that any infrastructure project in India right now takes 4 to 5 years. So that is the time period investor has to keep in mind before he thinks of exiting his investment.
So what are the biggest risks both end users and investors should guard against while buying the property near expressways?
See, one risk we already know is the land acquisition, which I talked about. Land acquisition has become tougher and tougher in India with the new land acquisition bill. Now we are struggling to acquire land for developing any infrastructure, be it airport, be it expressway, be it a road project itself. So that risk, and so like recently a new expressway has been announced by Prime Minister Narendra Modi, which is Delhi Meerut Expressway. If you look at that, in this the requirement of land is around 350 hectare. And out of the 345 hectare has already been acquired. So the risk involved here is very, very less. But if you look at the Eastern Peripheral Expressway or the Western Peripheral Expressway, Kundli Manesar Palwar Expressway, there's still 150 or 200 hectare of the land has to be acquired. So this is a very high risky project because we're not sure whether it will complete because of land acquisition. So first issue is obviously land acquisition. Then you have to also look at the funding. Who is funding this particular project? Is it being funded by the state government or the central government? Are they serious about it? Because many times it will happen that if the central government is funding a project in a state where they are not in power, typically the decisions are not made. So you have to look at who is in power and what kind of relationship the two governments have right now. And third is the execution risk, which is always there, but that is still, you can say, defined timeline where a contractor is not delivering in time, or the agency which is supposed to complete the project is taking a little more time. That risk is still under control of the agency and we can get it done.
Thank you for being on our show, Mr. Dhawan.
Thanks, Shweta.
Keep watching Prop Guide and stay tuned.